Listen to the rain, isn't it wonderful? In California, we've had this extremely bad drought. It's very, very worrisome. Continue this winter. And they blame it on what's called a ridiculously resilient ridge, RRR. This 4 mile high ridge of what, high pressure along the Pacific, I think the northern Pacific area. Somehow it pushes and blocks storms from coming in here. And it seems like this world has a ridiculously resilient ridge that seems to be blocking any awakening, realization, whatever you want to call it or not call it. It seems like we're blocked, you know, a lot of clouds, clouds but no rain. So we're trying to break down this ridiculously resilient spiritual pressure system, high pressure system that seems to be interfering with our success in normalizing. So I'm trying to introduce some terminology and ways of looking at it that are helpful to break this down. And I think normalizing is a really, really great way of looking at it. As we normalize, we set down the belief in specialness. Is what we're doing. That's all we're doing. So we're sort of taking out enlightenment, realization, awakening, this and this and this. No, just normalizing. Just normalizing. We're just accepting what we are, as we are, just accepting ourselves as God created us, which is spirit. I'm not a body, I am free, I'm still spirit, exactly as God created me. And anything other than that is the belief in specialness. And the belief in specialness is entirely there in order to project guilt upon it, and try to get rid of guilt. By the way, the storm is, like you can hear, it's very gusty and windy. And I went outside to look at it and see how flooded the road was and everything. As I'm standing in the rain with an umbrella, I see this great white crane-like bird. A snowy egret is the name of the bird. Great white snowy egret. And it's flying like this and sailing in the midst of this tempest. And it swoops down and lands right on the fence, right nearby here. And I'm just watching, I'm just looking at the fence. And wow, never seen anything like that before. And then later on, it takes off on the fence and goes over the road, and it's gliding and its wings like this. And the wind is just, ferocious. It's like, that's really interesting. Some kind of sign that the Holy Spirit can come visit us even in this very stormy time, huh? Absolutely. Stay here for a while and then take gliding off across the road somewhere. So, nice symbology right there. Because the world is very stormy, very ridiculous, resilient ridge. Now, all bodies, worlds, situations, circumstances are all there because of our belief in specialness. And we want to have something to project guilt on that we think is outside of our mind. That's how we think we can get rid of it. And we think that bodies, mind, bodies, worlds, situations, circumstances, things, time, space, process, form, is outside of our mind. And we're viewing it, we're aware of it as outside. And this is not true. There's nothing outside of our mind. But we need to believe it's outside of our mind so that we can project guilt upon it and think then we got the guilt's now gone from the mind, it's now on the bodies, and then kill the bodies, and that means then guilt's finally completely gone. This is what's going on. Guilt arises when we try to be greater than God and be out, and be beyond the all-inclusive. Thinking that we now are objectifying the all-inclusive, that we're some awareness beyond it that's able to objectify it. And when we try to objectify the all-inclusive, we really have a blank mind, and we feel this feeling of guilt, like there's something wrong, something wrong, something wrong. And we're so frantic, it's terrible, what do I do? Oh, let's imagine there's something outside of our mind, body, time, space, body, and form, project it onto the guilt onto that, and then kill that, and then we're free of it. This is our delusion, in a nutshell. So this is the belief in specialness. The body's special. The body can be sick. The body can be this. The body can be that. The body can die. No, there's nothing external to the mind. And the mind is perfectly free. And so the mind can imagine whatever it wants. The mind can imagine the body in this condition. The next instant can be some completely different condition. So there is no actual condition. In pure freedom, there's no condition because there's no duration to it, no inherent duration to anything other than our desire that it be there for us to experience. And if we want to experience something else, we can change it. So there's no circumstances, no situation, nothing like that. And so, but we want to believe in specialness. The body's special. The body can get sick. The body can age. The body can do that. So this is the belief in specialness. This is the cause of all our angst, all our suffering, all our misery, everything. Is our belief we want it to be special, so we can think that we're projecting on something outside of our mind. So that we can get rid of the guilt that way. We think, oh, the guilt's finally outside of our mind, as if there's... And of course, believing that we're outside of reality, we have no trouble believing that there can be something outside of our mind, you see. We're rejecting the all-inclusiveness of reality. That's what we're doing. So. What we're doing is going back to normalcy here. What we're doing here, going back to normalcy, normalizing. We're making a transition to normalcy. Making a transition to normalcy. And we don't have to visit the plastic surgeons or take hormones or anything like that. We're just transitioning to normalcy. What we do is we become more and more professional in what we're doing, more and more aware, work at it more and more and more, and of course you have to be totally involved in your own transitioning to normalcy. It's not something someone else can do for you. Someone else can transition normalcy, but if you haven't done it, then you haven't done it. So yeah, something you have to do. You can use others who have done it as role models and encouragement from that, but you still have to be totally involved in your own transition back to normalcy, setting the belief in specialness down. This is what we are engaged in right here, right now. And so, every day is another opportunity to go even further in that transition back to normalcy. So don't let anything get in the way of practicing in a positive vein. When you practice in a positive vein, you realize that there are no circumstances or situations outside you. That doesn't exist, and you just accept it that you need to. Once we transition back to normalcy, there won't be any problems. There won't be anything that bothers us. Actually, we have to have faith in that we presently are using excuses not to transition back to normalcy. Say, well, I would do it, except I can't because of this excuse or something. And so to be professional, more and more professional, you can't make excuses. You say, yeah, I have this great excuse, but I'm not going to use it. You see, we all have great excuses not to do it. Now, this is part of our projection of guilt ideas is no. We say, no, the body's outside of us. We can't. We have no control over the body. We say, we have no control over the world. We have no control over circumstances. We can't do anything about it. It's outside of us. That keeps alive the belief we can project guilt upon it all. When we start saying it's not outside of us, then how can we project guilt upon it and get rid of guilt, even believe we can do that? We cannot. So our whole scheme collapses, as it were. It doesn't work. And of course, we don't need to project guilt. All we have to do is forgive ourselves for trying to be greater than God and just accept ourselves as normal. That's all. Just because we tried to be fail to be greater doesn't mean then that we're somehow less. Does not mean that. We're just normal. We're normally perfect. Normally perfectly free. So we drop the excuse making. Just drop the excuse making and we know that sure, we've got great excuses. Everybody does. Has great excuses not to succeed. To fail. And say, well, I'd do it, except. And that goes on for a whole lifetime. This is what people do. We play this game of taking turns kicking off, basically. This is what we do, is we basically take turns dying. And you say, okay, it's your turn to die. Okay, now it's my turn to die. And, okay, my turn to die. And then it goes on. Everybody's just kind of playing this game of, okay, now it's my turn to die. It just is a game of kicking off, dying. That's all. That's just a silly little game. As if the body's external to the mind, you see? The mind can have the body appear any way, which way it wants to have it appear. It can have it appear dead, it can have it appear alive, it can have it not appear at all. It's entirely a figment of our imagination, all of this. It's all in our mind. There's nothing outside of our mind. This is the nature of mind. Some people call it consciousness. There's nothing outside of consciousness. There's nothing outside of mind. Everything is of the nature of mind. Everything is of the nature of consciousness. Not that we quite understand what that means at this point, but don't worry about it. It's not important. What's important is practicing. Practicing, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I know I'm already successfully normal. I don't need to become successfully normal. I know I'm already successfully normal. I don't need to become successfully normal. So I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. And I'm using this all during the day now as much as possible. Just like breathing. Oh yeah, I need to breathe. I need to go back to that. And just keep repeating this. And it's really, really powerful. It's dredging up more and more and more and more and more. It seems like there's a lot to dredge up. And we just have to keep doing this. This is what being a professional is all about, is you, instead of complaining and say, well, it's someone else's fault, say, you know, ultimately it's my fault. You know, everything that's happening is actually, it's because of me. It's my own thinking, my own desire and defenses that are responsible. So I have to keep practicing. It's not the Holy Spirit's fault. It's not God's fault. It's not the Holy Spirit's fault. It's my, you know, defenses to try and project guilt and get rid of guilt that's responsible for this. So I just have to keep practicing is the answer. That's the increased professionalism is to say, okay, I just got to keep practicing and just keep practicing. It's like a musician can't play the song and they blame the audience. If I had a better audience, I could play this song. You know, that's not professional. Professionally, say, it doesn't matter the audience, I can play the song anyway. If I can't play it, it's because I gotta keep practicing. Because certainly our defenses are not going to just leave us just on a whim. I mean, they're there out of fear. And feeling that we have to get project guilt and then kill the body. And then get rid of guilt that way. And so those defenses are going to hang in there tough, for sure. And so we have to be tougher than the defenses, and we have to continue to practice. Now, one of the most important practices is to say, I'm already enlightened. I'm already enlightened, and I'm just getting used to it. I'm in the wow mode. I'm in the wow mode, which is actually true. It's just that, without focusing that we're in that wow mode, without accepting it, we try to ignore it and then keep on with this projection. But we already are what we are. So you can say, I'm already enlightened, actually. It's just, and so I'm in the wow mode of recognizing this. I'm just in the wow mode of recognizing this. I'm already normal, actually. We're all normal. We're just dreaming we're not. And so we're transitioning back to normal. We just reached this wow. Wow, I'm already normal. Wow, I'm already normal. It's not like we get to a point and say, wow, I finally reached enlightenment. No, we say, wow, I'm already enlightened. I see I'm already normal. I'm already normal. Reality's already normal. It's already real. Reality's already, it's always been real. It's not like I made it real. Like, oh, I finally made reality real. I'm enlightened. It's not like that at all. So it's already real. So this is the humility, this is the practice we have to have, is I'm already enlightened. Wow. And try to stun yourself with the wowness, with the realization of this. Not just a mental thing, but actually feel like you're realizing I'm already normal. I'm already enlightened. I'm already all-inclusive. This isn't something that I accomplished or attained, or, you know, constructed or built or reached or anything. I'm already here. So I'm already here. I know that I'm already successfully here. I don't need to become successfully here. I know I'm already successfully realized. I don't need to become successfully realized. I know I'm already successfully enlightened. I don't need to become successfully enlightened. I know I'm already successfully normal. I know I don't need to become successfully normal. I know I'm already successfully here. I don't need to become successfully here. I know I've already successfully arrived. I don't need to successfully. I know I've already successfully arrived here. Well, I'm going to say, I know I'm already successfully here. I don't need to successfully arrive here. I know I'm already successfully here. I don't need to successfully arrive here. So I'm already feeling the effect of this practice now. A subtle shift. I feel a little different. So the wow factor is to realize that I'm already here. This is very much a very powerful technique in I know I'm already successfully here. I'm already here. Wow, I'm already here. Try that. Wow, I'm already here. So this practice brings a very strong wow, a tremendous reaction. Gets past concepts, doesn't it? I'm already here. Very little you can do conceptually with that, right? I'm already here. Wow, I'm already enlightened. Wow, reality is already real. Wow, I'm already normal. Using this very strong medicine. No doubt about it. It's like you take a strong medicine, not that I do, but you feel like it hit a strong effect upon you. It's like, wow, this is a strong medicine. This is very strong medicine, spiritual medicine. Wow, I'm already here. Wow, I know I'm already here. We think we're in the process of arriving, of getting here. So we have to jump out of that. You'll never finish that way. You're always almost arriving, but you never quite arrive. What we have to do is say, no, I'm already here. Wow, I know I'm already here. It was just a dream that I wasn't here. I know I'm already here. We've just been having a dream of arriving. But at some point, you have to confront the fact you never left. You're already here. You're just dreaming. As long as you stay in the dream, you never actually arrive. There's always some distance. So, we're saying, wow, I'm already here. Wow, I'm already enlightened. See, that cuts all the dialogue off, doesn't it? It really does. So the way we need to practice now given the situation, the world, so speculation, blah, 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 out. Because we're just in the wow, I'm already enlightened. What do I need to speculate on? I don't need to speculate on anything. I know I'm already enlightened. There's no how did I get here? I'm already here. This is the wow. The wow isn't how did I get here? No, the wow is I realize I'm already here. Does this put a conceptual strain on us? Absolutely it does. This is where the discipline comes in, the professionalism, the discipline. Don't spin it. No, stay in the no-spin zone. See, there is no external realization of what we are because there's nothing external to us. So the idea that we can reach what we are, something external, an external consciousness, or finally getting back and reaching what we are, can't ever happen. Can't ever happen. That can only be dreamed about. So you can have a dream of a spiritual path, a dream of towards enlightenment, all that. You can have a dream of enlightenment, but that's not it. We're already enlightened. I'm already here. You can only realize that I'm already here. I know I've already successfully realized that I'm already here. I know I've already successfully realized that I'm already successfully here. We're keeping that term successfully because we're so accustomed to trying to succeed. So ultimately you can drop that term also, but it's a helpful expedient, so that's why I'm using it here. And you see, we say, I know I'm already here. Wow, I know I'm already here. We might say, well, how did you get here? And we'd say, well, we'd say, no, I only had an hallucination, a dream that I wasn't here, but it was false. I had a false hallucination that I was somewhere else. That's all. I'm already here in the inclusiveness. I know I'm already here in the inclusiveness. I know I'm already successfully here in the inclusiveness. I know I'm already successfully here in the inclusiveness. And how do I feel right now? Just wow. It's just, this is strong medicine, that's all. You see, if there's nothing outside of the all-inclusiveness, how can you arrive back in it? How can something arrive back in it, or attain it, or realize it, or how can, see? So you can only say, I've already realized that I'm already here in the all-inclusiveness. Taking it out of the dream, saying, already, it's already happened. Don't look for it in the dream. It's already happened. this is using transitional terminology here. Remember, we're in transition in our analysis. I'm using transitional terminology. Of course, if you over intellectualize it, you can outsmart yourself and say, well, we can use more abstract terms and blah blah blah. Yeah, but we're in transition, so we're using transitional conceptual terminologies here. It's like if you're riding a bike, you ride the bike. If you're driving a car, you drive the car. So we're using helpful transitional terminology here. And actually, you don't even need to use abstract terminology, because once you realize that you're already here, you don't need any transitional help at all. You're already and so you might talk about an abstract way, but it's not a practice, and you don't need to practice in a total abstract way, because that would, if that's all you need, total abstraction, then you already have, you know that you're already here and you're completely comfortable with it. There's no need to practice at that point, you see. So we're using helpful transitional terminology. I know I'm already successfully here. Now, obviously, practicing like this is very helpful if you have a place where people are not going to interrupt you, and you don't need to do anything, and you're comfortable with where you are, and you just say, I've already arrived at where I am. I know I'm already successfully here. This is so different of a perspective that we're looking at, that it's just about pragmatically not feasible to really focus and allow yourself to feel this as you're going about busy, you know, interruptions and this and talking to people, because it's just so different, isn't it? So I know I'm already successfully here. Transitioning to normality, I know I'm already successfully here. Full stop in the wow. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I know I'm already successfully here. running into a lot of resistance. Ridiculous and resilient rich. Okay, so you have to break that down, keep breaking it down. This is what shunts away the realization. I know I'm already realized. I know I'm already successfully realized. I don't need to succeed at successful realization. I'm already successfully realized. I know I'm already successfully enlightened. Working to break down this ridiculous resilient ridge of resistance. I know I'm already successfully enlightened. So I'm experiencing this mental resistance now, yeah, okay. So this really kicks it up. So let's see what we can do about this. It's good when you get this resistance, don't struggle with it, it's good. Don't try to solve it right away. This is really meeting some ferocious argumentation and disputation here. It's as if there's a friend talking and saying, hey, you know, you're angry, what are you talking about? You're enlightened, you're saying you're enlightened, you know? And there's just really this angry, fearful exchange. So instead of putting yourself into that exchange, just say, oh, there's resistance, great. Don't struggle with it. That's why I say, don't struggle with the struggle. Some part of you jumps up and starts struggling, trying to struggle with you. Let's wrestle. You say, oh, great, somebody wants to wrestle, struggle. You don't struggle, you just stay calm and just say, okay, it's fine, that's wonderful. This means it's really, you know, smoking it out, right? You want to get the pests out of your house, smoke them out. Something hiding in under your house, start putting smoke under the house. Yeah, they'll come out ready to fight, you know? So this tells us that this practice is very, very powerful. It's like smoking out those resistances that are very much entrenched. All of them. You got to come out of the darkness, and they're very angry at you. I had a really good hiding place there. It's keeping you frightened, and now I have to come out. I want to go back. No, you can just stay right here. We're not going anywhere. So, you feel someone has a very negative attitude towards this. Great. Don't struggle with it. Don't struggle with it. Don't try to change their mind. Don't try to struggle with it. Say, I'm not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. What are this resistance protecting? Specialists. Oftentimes they act like your friend. That they're like your friend. That's what I had just experienced, like some good friend, and they got suddenly got so angry. Like, what do you mean you're already here? That's it. What are they afraid of? Specialists. They want you to see them as special, as outside of you, and you outside. And they want to see you as outside of them. And they say, well, if it's all inclusive, I won't be special. Well, that's right. But you'll still be just as much as a friend as everybody else is a friend. You'd be treated even with much more consideration and kindness. So I know I'm already successfully here. I know I'm already successfully here. I am already successfully here. I know 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 I am already normal. 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 Runs into tremendous opposition. That's okay. I know. I know I'm already successfully normal. I know I am already successfully normal. I know I'm already successfully here. Don't analyze the resistance, because we're practicing, so don't analyze the resistance. Don't analyze why someone is saying something, what they are, why their attitude is, why. Just keep practicing. Because we know that what we're doing is going to work. That's all that matters, right? So I know I am already here. I know I'm already successfully here. I know I'm already successfully here. I know I'm already successfully normal. I know I'm already successfully normal. I know I'm already successfully normal. And see, those other thoughts don't matter because I know I'm already here. I've already succeeded. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I'm already here. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I'm already here. What we have to do is just accept this, not argue with somebody. If something's already happened, why are you arguing whether it happened or not? You're arguing, it's ridiculous. They're saying, well, where in the dream did this happen? No, it already happened. Where in the dream did you arrive? I already arrived. I'm already here. I already arrived where I am. I'm already arrived. I'm already arrived using language, a transitionary language. I'm already arrived. This resistance wants to push you into completely abstract talk, which is too scary for us, so it's trying to get you to fail. So continue with this transitional way of saying, I've already arrived. Because they can pick a bone of contention with that and say, wait a minute, you know, if you've never left, how can you arrive? See, that's total abstraction. So we're transitioning to normalcy here. So we're saying, we're practicing our transition to normalcy, so we're saying, I've already arrived. I said, who? It doesn't matter who's disagreeing, because I've already arrived. What does it matter who's disagreeing? It doesn't matter at all, actually. So I don't need to be interested in, well, who am I overcoming? What do you mean, who am I overcoming? I'm already here. I've already succeeded. I don't need to worry about who I'm overcoming. That's ridiculous. It's already finished. I know I've already successfully finished. I don't need to look around like, who am I running from? Who am I beating? Who am I escaping from? I've already finished. I'm already here. The dream figures are screaming, I don't see any evidence you escaped me. You just disappeared. I don't know where you are. Yeah, but come back. You have to succeed in escaping me. And you know, I've already succeeded in escaping. Already succeeded. This is not language that the dream can accept or understand. So this is why you're breaking with the dream. Okay, deciding I'm no longer going to dream. That's all. And we've been dreaming for so long, the dream is trying to call us back into it. Say, hey, you gotta function according to the parameters of the dream. No, I know. Succeeded in realizing I'm already here. I'm already normal. And as you keep saying that, the dream starts fading away, fading away, fading away, fading away. Calling you to show yourself and prove that you've succeeded. And I say, I've already succeeded. It's too late to prove anything. I've already succeeded. It's too late to prove anything. Too late for proof. There's nothing to prove it to. It's too late for proof. I realize there's nothing to prove it to. So it's too late for proof. It's too late to be a hero of the dream. It's too late for proof. and I'm already here. It's too late to try and defeat anything, and I'm already here. It takes the whole dream out of the picture. It's like the dream is saying, well, you have to succeed in convincing me that you've got freedom. No, don't. I'm already here. I know. I'm already successful. I'm already successfully here. So obviously, needing to prove to the dream isn't true, because I know I'm already successfully here. It's already happened. So you're claiming that I need to do something. Obviously, that's a mistake, because I've already succeeded without doing that. So it's finished. It's over. It's already over. It's already finished. I've already succeeded. I'm already here. Talk that I need to do something to get here is ridiculous. Imagine you're sitting right here and somebody comes up and tells you, hey, you're not here yet because you haven't yet done this and this and this. You need to do that before you're here. And I say, what are you talking about? I'm already here. This is like, well, exactly like what it is. Someone's coming to you mentally, you're saying, hey, you know, you haven't finished. You have to do all this. You need to do all this other stuff. You need to do all this stuff before you can finish. Everybody's that way. There's no way they can finish without doing all this. Say, what are you talking about? I've already finished. I didn't do any of that stuff. I'm already finished, so you must be mistaken. I know I'm already successfully free. So anyone who claims that I still need to do anything in order to be successful, I need to do anything, must be mistaken. They have to be mistaken, right? Obviously. I know that I'm already successfully free. So there can't possibly be something that I still need to be free. Can't possibly be. Those who are claiming that, that's just a mistaken claim, insanity. What they're saying is, well, we're beyond freedom, we're beyond all inclusiveness, and you still haven't reached that. You see, you still haven't reached that, so you haven't really finished. This is the game they're playing. They're like spokespersons for what's beyond the all-inclusiveness. I say, okay, great, you realize that you're in the inclusiveness, but you still haven't realized you're beyond the inclusiveness. I say, it's too late. It's too late for proof. I'm already here. I know I'm already successfully here. Then the guilt is, they'll try to use the guilt, say, well, you're being inferior to us, and that's making us feel, we're superior, so you're making us feel guilty. I say, no, you're making yourself feel guilty by trying to be superior. I'm not trying to be superior. I'm not trying to make guilt by being inferior, because I'm just normal. I'm not inferior to normalcy, and everything is normal. The attempt to be greater is futile from the beginning. So you can't say there's ever been any guilt whatsoever, actually. Any actual cause of guilt whatsoever. Guilt itself is a delusion, because there's never been any cause for it. Because we never succeeded at all in being greater than God or being beyond all-inclusiveness. Never. So we're actually, I would say, imagining the guilt too. Imagine saying, well, we did it. Oh my God, it makes me feel terrible. You know, wow. We didn't do it. Nobody ever has been abnormal. So the feeling of guilt is our first primary, is our primary hallucination that we actually succeeded in some way. I am free, and I am still spirit exactly as God created me. And the mind will try to wander. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. So just drop it. Whatever you're thinking, just catch it as quick as you can. Just drop it right that instant. And go to I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. It's too late for proof. It's too late for proof. I know I'm already successful here. I don't need to prove anything to someone who claims I'm not already here when I know I'm already here. Obviously, want to insist that I need to do something first to be here. That's all. I know I'm already here. So I know obviously I don't need to do anything first to be here if I'm already here. That's the end of it. There isn't any call for proof at all. There isn't anything outside of all inclusiveness. There are many who claim that they speak for what is outside of all inclusiveness, but they're just hallucinating, just having a insane dream, just rambling and insanity. How can there be a spokesperson for what doesn't exist? How can there be a spokesperson for nothing? How can there be a spokesperson for what doesn't exist? How can someone claim to be channeling what doesn't exist? Saying they're a spokesperson for what doesn't exist. Saying that this is what doesn't exist, this is what they're demanding proof that they don't that doesn't exist. How can what doesn't exist, how can what does not exist demand proof that it doesn't exist? Some will claim, well, I have a memory, I was there, and so I'm remembering what I was told. How can you be somewhere that doesn't exist? And then remember what you were told by what doesn't exist. How can anyone say that? Yeah, it's insanity. And you see, everyone's all-inclusive, but there are people, spirits, who say, yeah, I might be all-inclusive, but I remember a time when I wasn't. That's not true. I remember a time when I wasn't, and I'm just, you know, need to combine the two. No. How can we remember a time that never existed? How can we remember a place, going to a place that never exists, never existed, doesn't exist? So they're just assuming that they're just believing, assuming, and pretending, and imagining that they did it, though they didn't. They haven't gone anywhere, except they're already here, already successfully here. Everyone's already successfully here, no matter what they say. I remember I had a dream where I was enlightened, and in this dream I came across this yogi on the side of the road, or some sadhu, or some mendicant pilgrim, some, you know, religious person who practicing, and they were just in rags, and they were sitting practicing, and they were just talking. And it's just this crazy talk they were talking, just absolute babbling insanity. And I was like, whoa, I sort of lost my enlightenment by listening to them. And this is what the trouble, ridiculously resistant ridge is. It is all of those who are already here, insisting that they're not already here, that they're coming in from somewhere else. So what we say is we give them the tools to make a transition in normalcy, meaning putting down the belief in specialness, not putting down specialness because that doesn't exist. It's never existed, but putting down the belief that it could, putting down the belief in specialness is what it's all about. The body, there's never been anything external in mind, but we're putting down the belief that there has been. See, they believe that they're external to the all-inclusiveness. So they're sitting there babbling, like they're some kind of spiritual guru, they're in some spiritual state that's outside of the all-inclusiveness, and they're telling us about it, and they're trying to teach us about it, you know, and that can be very toxic lose your realization of that you're already here. Everyone's already here. So there's somebody sitting right here who's already here talking about they're somewhere else. And you can't get fooled by that. No, I'm already here. You're already here. Everything's already here. They might be saying, well, I'm accessing higher states of consciousness and that all consciousness is already here. Consciousness is already rooted in consciousness. Consciousness comes from consciousness. Nowhere else. It's not some other source. You didn't tap into some other source. They may say, no, 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 I'm about to reach the ultimate. Stop, 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 I'm not ready. What do you mean? I know I've already successfully reached the ultimate. What do you mean I'm about to? There's no about to. I know I've already reached it. I've already reached it. I know I've already successfully reached the ultimate. Everyone's already successfully reached the ultimate. There are some quote-unquote spiritual talkers that, say, no, I've already reached. Everyone's already reached the ultimate, successfully reached the ultimate. And without a trace of the reaching. It was a traceless, baseless reaching. It's already reached it. And so there's no proof because it's already happened and there's no trace. The reaching. Not even a ripple. Not even a ripple. It's too late for proof. It's already happened without a ripple, without a trace. It's too late for proof. It's already happened without a trace. So we're working to break down this ridiculously resilient ridge of resistance. And yeah, it has to be done. Otherwise, we'll stay in this terrible drought. Spiritual drought. We're in a spiritual drought in this world, actually. That's something that should be very apparent to all of us. We're in a very bad spiritual drought. And we can get that way if we're not careful. We weren't careful enough. That's what happened. We let our guard down because of radio, ultimately television, movies, and technology, high technology. All of this keeps coming. And we say, oh wow, I would be spiritual practicing, but wait a minute, this stuff's very interesting. Look at all this music I can listen to. Look at all these movies I can watch. Look at all this technology I can, all these buttons. Oh, what if I press this button, what happens? What if I scroll into this? Let me check this menu out. What can this do? On and on and on. Yeah, I'll practice, but just once. Wait a second. So really what it is, we've had like 100 years of wait a secondness. And when you do that, this builds up this ridiculously resilient ridge of resistance. And this is the problem. And then you go into a spiritual drought. And when you go into a spiritual drought, then you really are in trouble. In terms of delay. Because then you tend to gravitate towards the CCC, as it were. Bringing in their pseudo-spirituality, which is superficial bureaucracy. They say, that's not what we need, though. We need real spiritual teaching. I know, it's too late for proof. It's already happened without a trace. It's too late for proof. See, this is what we need. Not the CCC saying, don't worry, we'll organize everything down to the last minutia. We'll have everything being monitored. We'll get driverless cars, and everything will be taken care of technologically, and you'll feel fine. No more drought. it just camouflages the spiritual drought as well, what it does. That's like, for instance, let's say there's a severe drought in California, and they can't plant any crops, and the CC, you know, it's just barren fields, and we're like, oh my God, this is horrible. And the CCC comes in and says, don't worry, we have the answer. So what do, they go out and place plastic lettuce in the fields everywhere, and monitors on them, and hook it everything up. Like, they look and say, oh, no, look at that field of healthy lettuce. Wow. Yeah, it's all plastic. And they have people go out there harvesting. They show, you know, the happy proletariat harvesting. Our comrades are harvesting the wonderful lettuce crop this year. But look how healthy the lettuce is. You go out there and look, it's all plastic. It's all plastic. And we're monitoring the exact weight and the growth of this lettuce. They don't let you see, of course, because the growing of it, because it doesn't grow, it's all plastic. Actually, it's probably like a hologram. They set up lasers and holograms, so there's a hologram of lettuce. And they can make that seem like growing by showing some video, holographic video of lettuce growing in a field. When you go out there to pick the lettuce, there's nothing there. There's nothing there. Spiritual drought leaves you very vulnerable to CCC. And of course, they're the ones who made the drought in the first place with all this radio, television, movies, high technology, computers, high technology, all this stuff. Firing our imagination, all the marketing, advertising, education, all of this stuff. They're the ones who precipitated the drought in the first place. And they come in and say, oh my God, you got a terrible drought. Drought here, huh? Okay, we got the answers for that. We'll just fake a recovery from the drought, but it's not really a recovery. We'll just get you so engrossed in stuff that you won't even notice there's a drought. But the spiritual drought remains. So it's too late for proof. I'm already here. I'm tracelessly here. I'm already tracelessly here. It's too late for proof. I'm already tracelessly here. So it's difficult for us because there is this terrible spiritual drought. And so there's a lack of momentum. So that's why it's seeming to be somewhat difficult, but it always is somewhat difficult. It's too late for proof. I know I'm already successfully here. It's too late for proof. I know I'm already baselessly, tracelessly, successfully here. It's too late for proof. Too late for proof. I know I'm already sitting successfully here, and there's only here. There's only here. There's no proof of here, because it's too late for proof. There's only here. It's already only here. It's already only here. Now, see, we think we need to convince someone, the ego, that we're here. And this is the problem. We don't need to convince the ego of anything. It's too late. It's too late to convince the ego. The ego's already gone. Just a memory that we're dealing with. The ego's already gone. It's already finished. It's already vanished. Remember, we're doing this as practicing. This is not spiritual rhetoric. We're imagining that this is so. We're accepting this is so. This is practice. The ego's already vanished. Without a trace. Gone without a trace. There's not the slightest trace that the ego ever was, actually. So what do we see now? Well, we see that the Holy Spirit is. But there's not the slightest trace that the ego ever was. Vanished without a trace. Vanished without a trace that it ever was. Too late for proof. The ego's absolutely vanished without a trace that it ever was. Too late for proof, I'm already here. Transitioning to normalcy. Transitioning to normalcy. It's like coming out of a hallucinatory dream. We can't keep referencing the dream because it's vanishing. How can the dream vanish if it keeps saying, I need to reference. Wait a minute, come back. No, you just have to let it dissipate, let it evaporate. gone without a trace. So just imagine that it's already gone without a trace. I can't reference it. It's already gone. I can't reference the dream. It's already gone. I can't reference the dream. It's already gone without a trace. Put yourself in that situation. I can't reference a dream. It's already vanished without a trace. So get used to that fact. It's shocking, stunning, right? I can't reference the dream because it's already vanished without a trace. I can't prove anything to the dream. It's already vanished without a trace. I can't prove the dream that I'm already here because it's already vanished without a trace. So maybe you have this sadhu frantically saying all these things, and you say, sadhu, I can't. You're trying to get rid of something that's already gone. Trying to get rid of something that's already gone without a trace. To use transitional language. Is already gone without a trace. You don't need to keep it gone. It's absolutely vanished without the slightest trace it ever was. So in trying to keep it gone, you're actually trying to reference at least to some extent that it has some appearance or some aspect to it in some way. It doesn't have there's not a slightest trace of it that it ever was. There's not a slightest trace that it ever was. So why do you spend all your time trying to get rid of it or make it stay gone? Like make it stay dead. It's dead and they gotta stay dead. There's no trace that ever was. So it's not a question of whether it's dead or not. There's no trace that ever was. The ego tricks us into trying to get rid of it, you see. So we'd say, no, it's already gone. It's already vanished without a trace. Of course, if you're trying to get rid of something, that means it must be there. But we're not trying to get rid of the ego. The ego's already vanished without a trace. It's already vanished without a trace. But there's no evidence it ever was. This is what we're practicing in our mind. And our expectations. See, we're aligning our expectations with the truth. didn't even have a chance to say goodbye. Ezra has already vanished without a trace. Already vanished without a trace. And I'm already here. With no trace of ever having ever arrived here. So I've already successfully arrived here. Without a trace of the arrival. Someone says, well, how'd you get rid of the ego? I don't know. It's already gone. It's already gone. It vanished without a trace. Already vanished without a trace. Or had any opportunity to assess anything about it. It's vanished without a trace. Already gone. Prior to my even thinking about it being gone, it was gone. It left so fast you could call it instantaneous. It was instantaneously gone. Without a trace. So there's nothing I can say about it. Nothing I can say about its leaving. It seemed to be here one moment, and the next moment, it was as if it was already gone. There wasn't any awareness of it leaving. There was only this feeling that it was already gone. And there's only the feeling that I'm already here. Of course, the ego wants to know, well, how did I leave? You know, it's very interesting. How did I leave? Can't help the ego because it was as if it had already been gone. It's not like there's this ego outside of everywhere, outside of all-inclusiveness, and we finally managed to get rid of that ego that was outside of all-inclusiveness. So, in transition, I can say, I have no idea. The ego is as if it's already gone. It's already gone. It vanished without a trace. There's nothing I can say about it. So there's no thinking that arises. There's no thoughts or concepts that arise around it. It's already gone. Without a trace. Transitional practice here. Transitioning to normal. So we're using all of our basic good habits, which is what being a professional is all about. Sitting quietly, here, sitting quietly, same place, not getting up. I did have to get up one time there. That was prep. Sometimes location, there are interruptions. I thought someone might be coming down to here, and I need to, you know, stop the taping. But other than those rare situations like that, we understand that there are occasionally situations like that. That's okay. We're not trying to say perfect or nothing here. We're saying sit quietly, right where you are. Don't go anywhere. Don't do anything. Okay, then full stop in the wow. These are habits. These are not absolutes. These are habits. To do as good, to do as well as we can at, but not striving for 100% perfection. We're just trying to do the very best we can at these habits. That's all. Just pause the video, put the video camera down, taking it off, and turn the light. You know, I could have done that, but that's a lot of action too. So I thought I just better just let me just peek in. Okay, there's nobody coming. That's fine. I don't want to be interrupted that way. Full stop in the now. Bringing the wowness up by what we're focusing on. Feeling the wow. Don't spin the wow. Try not to spin. If we start spinning it, go back to I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. And keep saying that over and over until the spin dissipates. So these are just the good habits. And then when we do these good habits, we're able to really, 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 really practice. I know I've already successfully succeeded. I know I've already successfully arrived. I know I'm already successfully here. Baseless, traceless. Absolutely nothing I can say about it because I know I'm already here. There's no evidence to talk about at all, except I know I'm already here. The ego's already vanished, leaving no trail, no trace. Nothing. There's absolutely nothing we can say. It's gone. Without a trace. And don't struggle with the struggle. So these are the basics. Sit quietly. Focus in on I know I'm already successfully here. For instance, I know I'm already successfully normal. Take that mental position. Okay, you're already what you are. I know I'm already here. I know I'm already here. So there's no arriving taking place, no action. You're talking from a standpoint of already being what you are. Already from being. You're talking from the standpoint of being. I'm already successfully being. I already successfully am. Not any happening, no causation of that. We're not talking about causation. I say it's too late for causation. I'm already it. It's too late for proof. I'm already it. It's too late for causation. I'm already it. And I can't find a trace of causation whatsoever. I'm already it. I'm just already it. So speak from that standpoint. And then this brings up the wow. Like, wow, this is just so amazing. I'm just okay. Then don't allow any spin. Full stop in the wow. And then don't struggle when the resistance comes up. Don't struggle with it. Praise the resistance. Say, oh, thank you. It's great. You're smoking it out. Wonderful. Just let it. Okay, you came out great. So some more. Fine. Let whatever come out arises. Let it arise. I'm not gonna struggle with it. And just go back. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Keep yourself centered. And these are the good habits. Let's listen to the rain a little bit here. Supposed to have thunderstorms this afternoon, possible lightning. It's the trail part of the storm, period part of it. It's very unstable air, I guess. So occasional rain. I know that I'm already successfully it. And I'm already successfully it. I know I'm already successfully included. It's too late for causation. There's not a trace of causation yet to be seen whatsoever. It's already too late for that. So all the demands I try to make myself, it's already too late for that. It's already too late. Vanish without a trace. Apparently, we say this transitional language, it vanished without a trace. I don't see any causation anywhere. I'm already it. I know I'm already successfully it. I know I'm already successfully included. I know I'm already successfully included. I am already successfully included without any causation whatsoever. No trace of causation anywhere. Everything is already what it is. Everything is already what it is. Not a trace of causation anywhere. Everything is already what it is. Everything is already included, all included, without a trace of causation. Everything is already included. Everything is already what it is. Allness is already allness. There's no trace of causation. Vanished without a trace, apparently, huh? No trace anywhere. Absolutely no trace. Staying in the wow. Don't start going into your intellect or thinking, how do you feel about feeling? You know, they're trying to still try and generate causation. No causation, no causation, no trace of any causation anywhere. Everything already is. No trace of derivativeness. At all. To everything. No trace of a past anything at all. Vanished without a trace. Without a trace. Now ultimately, the realization will dawn. Ultimately, we're not worried about that. Never was. But from our standpoint of transitioning, which is where we're at, and let's not do any gamesmanship like, we're still in. We're still in transitioning. So, passes, just vanish without a trace. No causation for it present. No trace of any causation for it whatsoever. Everything is completely without trace of causation. Without any trace of derivativeness. Without a trace of time, or space, or process, or form. Causing anything. Everything already is what it is. 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 So if you want to transition into normalcy, away from the belief in specialness, then you have to practice in some effective way like this. The ego's already vanished without a trace. It's already vanished. How did it vanish? It's already vanished. It's just already gone. It's already vanished. There's no trace anywhere. There's nothing I can say except that it's already gone. And of course, the ego say, "Well, wait a minute. Wait, I want to know how I vanished." Well, it is without a trace is how you vanished. Without a trace that you've ever been is how you vanished. And it's something that's already happened. It's not something that's happening now or going to happen. It's something that's already happened. Explain how everything is. There's no one there to explain to. It already looks the way that it looks. It's too late for explanation. It already looks exactly the way it looks. It's too late for explanation. Exactly as God created me. Don't struggle with the struggle. So a struggle arose. Started arising an argument and someone demanding something, an explanation. I said, no. Okay. Don't try to explain. Don't struggle with the struggle. Don't try to explain to some argument that demands explanation. It's too late for explanations. Everything's already happened. Everything already is what it is. There isn't any explanation. For causation, there's not a trace of causation, so it's not explainable. Everything already is successfully is what it is. It's too late. All explanations have vanished. All explanations for everything have already vanished, completely vanished without a trace. All explanations vanish without a trace. There isn't a trace of explanation to be found anywhere. So we're just getting used to this. It's very helpful. The only way to get used to it is to actually do it. Break the ice. Break down that ridiculously resilient ridge of resistance and actually, like, do it. Practice it like this. And by doing this, you say, I can do this. It's not that bad. There's some resistance that arises. That's fine. Not too bad. I'm able to, go back. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit. Exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created. Everything already is what it is. All that, all causation, no trace of causation, vanish without a trace. All explanation, vanish without a trace. Everything is completely traceless and baseless. It already is what it is. Everything already is what it is. This tree already is this tree. This tree already is this tree. All causation and explanation vanish without a trace. Completely, no trace whatsoever, vanish without a trace. This tree already is this tree. This hedge already is this hedge. These leaves already are these leaves. All causation vanish without, already vanish without a trace. All explanation already vanished without a trace. These leaves already are. Successfully these leaves. I know these leaves are already successfully these leaves. I know this tree is already successfully this tree. I know this plant is already successfully this plant. I know this post is already successfully this post. All explanation, all causation vanish without a trace. It's already vanished without a trace. Trouble that anyone could be having is if they try to take too high of an abstract position to impress someone special, maybe they're trying to impress, or trying to say they're very special, and that because they don't even need to use transitional practices like this, because they already grasp the high abstractness of language, and they don't need. That's the trouble you can get into, because then by practicing like this, those that you've been trying to impress, that you're so special, will say, why are you doing this? You don't need to do this. I mean, you're above that. You've told us you're above this. And so there's some who've gotten trapped into this, for sure. They need to practice this transitional practice, for sure. But it's beneath them. That's beneath me. I don't need to understand that. So we can use higher language, more abstractness. But that's not practicing anymore, really. And they say, well, I don't need to practice. I'm already there. I'm already there. I don't need to practice, right? And that's outsmarting yourself. Familiarity. Continuity problem. That's still there. Well, I should just be able to get rid of that. Well, continuity problem, familiarity is not a thing. It's not something, see, it's what you're used to. It's what you're habitually used to. It's not like I can just imagine familiarity problem gone. Because the familiarity problem entails everything that you're already used to. I can't help those who are in that, assuming that, you know, high position by claiming I'm in some higher position, because then I get trapped in the same problem. Absolutely. I'm down here with my work clothes on, you know, digging ditches. Absolutely. And uh, There's those who are trapped like that, that the ego has trapped them like that. The ego says, well, you don't need to do that because you said you've already transcended the ego, right? And if you haven't already done it, it means you haven't transcended the ego. But you, and so they get trapped in these mind games like this. And they say, well, I need a teacher who's like greater than any other teacher could possibly be. In fact, they transcend even the greatest that could possibly be. If that's the only teacher who could possibly help me. I said, yeah, I'm enlightened and I'm great and abstract. But oh, here's a teacher who's even more than that. And then they say, okay, they can help me. You know, something like that. But then that gets pretty tricky that way too, doesn't it? Yeah. They could say, well, the ego trapped me in this position, actually, and I understand this, so I'm now transitioning back to normal. They could say, well, sure, this abstraction, I have this high abstraction, but actually, this isn't the full normal. Okay, so I need to actually still transition from this to normalcy. Even this needs to be transitioned to normalcy. So you don't need some super guru up here like that, so to speak, the one that says it's greater than all than anyone could possibly ever be, and no one could ever touch this. You don't need that, actually. You just need to say, well, yeah, this, I'm in a very high place, but even this needs to be transitioned into normalcy. Even this needs to be transitioned into normalcy. And that's even a greater step, so to speak. And so then I can practice from that standpoint. Absolutely. And then all the devil does say, but you said you were going to, you said you were nice. Well, this is actually part of the transitioning, and you need also, devotees, to also complete your transitioning too. You see, it's not completed. There's one more step we have to do. One more. Okay, yeah. So yeah, there is a way. There is a way. And you see, you can say, well, actually, there is, the one more step is to realize that there's actually no trace whatsoever of my greatness. There's no causation level whatsoever. No trace. No causation. No proof. No proof whatsoever. No proof, no trace, no causation. So there's no point in even asserting it anymore. It's just now we're just enjoying working. I found a new gear of where I now feel I enjoy transitioning. One way or the other, they have to get out of that. Yeah, the ego can throw some nasty traps, and then if you're trying to help them, you can get pulled into those nasty traps too, actually. And of course, they claim, well, if anyone's to be helped, they are, of course, because they're so superior. In fact, they can actually help you. Yeah. You don't need to be doing those exercises. Now, let me help you. You don't need to be transitioning. I'm abstractly already understand that you're already here. But I haven't transitioned past the continuity fear. And of course, those who follow them don't want to either. Say, no, we don't want to actually do it. We just want to say, well, it is doable, but let's just assume that it's completely done without actually practicing the assumption that it's completely done. Because we're having too much fun with all these things. Drop that, I guess. We'll see what happens. All right. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am spirit. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. This tree. I know this tree. I know this is already successfully a tree. I know this tree already successfully is a tree. I know this tree already successfully is a tree. I know this walkway already successfully is this walkway. I know these clouds are already successfully these clouds. I know this light is already successfully this light. I know this table is already successfully this table. I know this bench is already successfully this bench, and the cause and the explanation have already vanished without a trace. I know already that this tree is successfully this tree. I know already that these stones, I know already that these stones are already successfully these stones. I know already that this successful tree is a tree. I know already that this successful